We're going to talk about an uncomfortable topic today. Hemorrhoids. I know, this is one of those health issues people like to keep deep inside, but there's a new risk factor for hemorrhoids that I need to share with you. Smartphones. More specifically, using your smartphone on the throne. There are already some well-established risk factors for hemorrhoids. Low-fiber diet, constipation, straining, obesity, pregnancy, a sedentary lifestyle. And then there's this issue of time spent on the toilet. The thing is, sitting on a toilet is not quite the same as sitting in a chair. Because of the design of the standard toilet seat, the pelvic floor is not supported. That can lead to engorgement of the pelvic veins, and big engorged veins is basically what hemorrhoids are. So, what's keeping us on the toilet so long? New data appearing in PLOS One this week puts the blame squarely on smartphones. Here's how the study worked. Researchers from Beth Israel in Boston enrolled patients undergoing routine screening colonoscopy. This is a real strength of this study. They aren't looking at self-reported hemorrhoids. They're looking at documentation of hemorrhoids by experts during a colonoscopy. It's worth noting here that not all hemorrhoids are painful. Those that are more internal, you may never know you have, but you can't hide them from your colonoscopist. Before the scope, participants took a bunch of surveys, diet, lifestyle, and bathroom habits, including whether they used a smartphone while they were in there. This was the first real shocking finding of this study. 66% of participants reported using a smartphone in the bathroom, meaning 34% do not use a smartphone in the bathroom? I had no idea that was even possible. What do you even do in there? And you're probably thinking they're just reading other things. No, according to the study, 88% of people who didn't bring a smartphone with them don't read anything on the toilet. As an aside, I am super guilty of loitering on my phone in the bathroom. Even in the pre-smartphone era, I was a bathroom reader, and if no books were available, I would read the ingredient list on shampoo bottles. Desperate, I know. But apparently, this is not the case for everyone. I am bewildered. But it's good that it's not the case that everyone brings their smartphone with them, or else there would be no control group in this study. Of course, there were some notable differences between the smartphone sitters and those stoic paragons of virtue who can be alone with their thoughts for a few minutes. Smartphone users were younger and had a lower physical activity score, for instance. And it may not surprise you, those who use smartphones spent way more time in the bathroom. Nearly 40% of them reported spending an average of more than 5 minutes on the toilet, compared to about 7% of non-smartphone users. Interestingly, most smartphone users said their phones didn't make them sit longer. Most of them said it never led to longer sitting times, which just goes to show that time flies when you're having fun. Given that this sitting is a potential problem, the authors examined the risk of finding hemorrhoids on that screening colonoscopy based on smartphone use. Just over 50% of smartphone users had hemorrhoids on colonoscopy, compared to 38% of non-users. After adjusting for known risk factors like fiber intake, reported straining, sex, and age, the authors found that smartphone use was associated with about a 50% increase in the odds of hemorrhoids. Okay, a few issues with this analysis. One big missing piece is that the authors don't assess whether time on the toilet is the thing that connects smartphones to hemorrhoids. They hypothesize that's the case, and it makes sense that that would be the case, but they have the actual data. They could show us, and yet it doesn't appear in their multivariable modeling. There's also some weirdness in the other risk factors, like BMI and straining, two very well-established hemorrhoid risk factors, had no significant effect on hemorrhoids in this study, and fiber intake appeared to increase the risk rather than decrease it. Now, this might be an artifact of the cross-sectional nature of the study. We can't assess with this design the arrow of causality. Like, it might not be that high fiber intake causes hemorrhoids, it's more likely that people with hemorrhoids subsequently increase their fiber intake. And I'll note here that taking fiber supplements counted as being on a high fiber diet in the author's framework. And that reverse causation is possible with smartphones too. Maybe smartphones lead you to spend more time on the toilet, but maybe people who spend longer on the toilet for other reasons are more likely to bring their smartphones to help pass the time rather than the other way around. In that case, the smartphone is not a causal factor at all, just an innocent bystander, a marker that says this is a person who needs a lot of bathroom time. The truth is, though, I suspect many of us spend longer than we should with our pelvic floors woefully unsupported because we're scrolling Instagram or reading an article or playing a mobile game or something. I mean, I've certainly been there, and that may not be great for us. As such, I'm going to do a bit of an experiment, leave the phone outside the bathroom door for a while. Perhaps it's good for my internal organs, perhaps not, but maybe stealing some time to simply be alone with my thoughts will have other benefits. For Medscape, I'm Perry Wilson.